Good afternoon, students. In previous class, we have seen what about root word, primary suffix, and even secondary suffix also. Root word mainly discusses with number of carbon atoms present in the compound. Second one, primary suffix discusses with saturation of the compound. Okay, saturation means we told if carbon-carbon double bonds are there throughout the compound, we will be ended with the primary suffix AN. Okay, if any one double bond is there at least, then it will be getting primary suffix en. If any at least one triple bond is there, then we will get ien. Like that we have seen. After that, secondary suffix. Secondary suffix will be followed by the functional group. Okay. If you have functional group, then only we will get secondary suffix. But before that, the names whatever I am going to explain from today onwards up to some days. Okay, 2 or 3 days like that, it will be taking for only root word and primary suffix only. After that, functional group. If functional group is named, then only we will come across with secondary suffix. Okay, at that time we will see. But before that, today we are going to see some names for three series of compounds. Those are alkanes, alkenes and alkynes. Okay, name itself, it is indicating AN, EN, IN. Okay, what is the meaning of that one and what about those compounds, all those things we will see. Before that, root word plus primary suffix. Root word plus primary suffix. If you have these two terms, okay, we can give the compounds, organic compounds contain carbon and hydrogen. Root word and primary suffix will be enough to give the names of the organic compounds contain only carbon and hydrogen. Okay, the compounds which contain only carbon and hydrogen are called hydrocarbons. The compounds which contain carbon and hydrogen only, no other element must be there, only carbon and hydrogen, those compounds are called hydro, is the term obtained from hydrogen, carbon, hydrocarbons. The compounds which contain only carbon and hydrogen elements are called hydrocarbons. Example, CH4, C2H6, C3H8, etc. These are all coming under hydrocarbons only because they only contain carbon and hydrogen. Okay, for this type of compounds, to give the name, it is enough with root word plus primary suffix. Is it okay, ma'am? If you have secondary suffix, then definitely functional group must be there. At that time, the time comes, I will tell that what about the functional group also when we have to use secondary suffix. Okay, now what about the hydrocarbons and how we are going to name the hydrocarbons, we will see today. Let us see that one. Hydrocarbons are classified into two types. Saturated hydrocarbons . First hydrocarbons means the compounds which contain only carbon and hydrogen. Okay, so those hydrocarbons are classified into two types, saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Okay, once again, hydrocarbons are classified into two types, saturated and unsaturated. Saturated hydrocarbons are the hydrocarbons which contains only carbon single bond carbons. only single bonds will be there between carbon and carbon. Saturated hydrocarbons are the hydrocarbons which contain only carbon-carbon single bonds. So if you see the total compound, okay, wherever we have seen, even carbon, 10 carbons are there. Between one carbon and another carbon, only single bonds will be there. We will not see, or we never see, double bonds and triple bonds between carbon and carbon. Then those type of compounds are called saturated hydrocarbons, which are also called alkanes. 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 One more time. Saturated hydrocarbons are the hydrocarbons which contain carbon-carbon single bonds. Nowhere we will see double bond and triple bonds in saturated hydrocarbons. Those are called saturated hydrocarbons. Saturated hydrocarbons are named as alkanes. 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 Next. Unsaturated hydrocarbons. Unsaturated hydrocarbons are the hydrocarbons which contain at least one carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bond. Unsaturated hydrocarbons are the hydrocarbons which contain at least one carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bond. Remaining might be single bonds, carbon-carbon single bonds, but at least one double bond must be there, or at least one triple bond must be there. Okay, once again, unsaturated hydrocarbons are the hydrocarbons which contain at least one carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bond. Okay, depending on this carbon-carbon double bond and carbon-carbon triple bond, unsaturated compounds are classified into two types. Unsaturated hydrocarbons are classified into two types. Okay, now let's see. Those are alkenes and alkynes. Alkenes and alkynes. Alkenes contain at least one carbon-carbon double bond. Alkenes contain at least one carbon-carbon double bond. Alkynes contain at least one carbon-carbon triple bond. So final conclusion is, unsaturated hydrocarbons are the hydrocarbons which contain carbon-carbon triple bond or carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bond, at least one carbon-carbon double bond or carbon-carbon triple bond. Okay, if total series of compound, if you observe the total compound, in that at least one carbon-carbon double bond is there, that is called alkene. At least one triple bond is there, that is called alkyne. While we were drawing the structures, you might have observed, we have seen ethane structure. Ethane, C2H6. In that ethane structure, between carbon and carbon, we have single bond. Between carbon and carbon, we have single bond. Okay, then that is alkane. Ends with ane. Alkane. Okay, second structure C2H4. Between carbon and carbon we have double bond. Between carbon and carbon we have double bond. Ethene. Correctly, if you remember, ethene comes under alkene. Okay, next, third structure C2H2. Between carbon and carbon we have triple bond. Okay, that is coming under alkyne. That's why its name is ethyne. E-T-H-Y-N-E, ethyne. Like that we have seen some names also. Once again we will see the names now separately. Okay, so once I am going to give conclusion for this entire table cover, that is hydrocarbons are classified into two types, saturated hydrocarbons and unsaturated hydrocarbons. Under saturated hydrocarbons we have only one type, that is alkanes. Under unsaturated hydrocarbons we have two types, those are alkenes and alkynes. Alkenes contain at least one double bond, alkynes contain at least one triple bond. Okay, if you have understood this one, we will go for how to give the names for alkanes, alkenes and alkynes. Okay, now shall we see that one? Okay, all of you be ready with the naming of hydrocarbons. Let us start with first alkanes. Okay, for every series of compounds we can give the general formula for easily remembering. Okay, so for alkanes the general formula is CnH2n+2, where n is number of carbon atoms present in that compound, where n is number of carbon atoms present in that compound. What is the general formula for alkanes? CnH2n+2. CnH2n+2. Okay, ma? Now let us see that one. Starts with alkanes. Okay, first compound A. C1. Start with C1. Okay, n is equal to 1. Keep this n is equal to 1 here in hydrogen. 2 into 1 plus 2. H4. CH4. Now let us start that name. Name contains root word plus primary suffix. Name contains root word plus primary suffix. This compound contains how many carbon atoms? One carbon atom. One carbon atom means root word meth. One carbon atom means root word meth. It contains single bonds, or at least this alkanes is there, na? Alkanes heading. In that alkanes end with ANE. That ANE is the primary suffix. Even primary suffix I told separately also. Okay, AN. Meth plus AN. Name of this compound will become methane. Name of this compound will become methane. Structure of this compound, C, single bond H, tetrahedral, already we know. The structures again and again, no need. Okay, easily understanding purpose, we have learnt already what are the structures, all these things. Now, simply what are the names we have to go through. Okay. This is the information about first compound under alkanes. First compound under alkanes. What is the first compound under alkanes? Methane. Okay, next, second compound B. Second compound is number of carbon atoms 2. Same thing. C2. Then n is equal to 2. Substitute this 2 in H. 2 into 2 plus 2. 6. C2H6. C2H6. What is the root word if number of carbon atoms 2? Root word eth. It comes under alkane only, because if you write the structure, it will be contained by only carbon-carbon single bond. Okay. Then what is the primary suffix? An. Then name of this compound is ethane. Ethane. C2H6 ethane. Now the structure of this C2H6 is carbon single bond carbon, H we have to adjust that surrounding carbon only 4 bonds must be there. If you have drawn 5 bonds, then definitely is wrong. Or 3 bonds also definitely wrong. Very rarely 3 bonds will be present. But major in every compound, okay, maximum in everything, carbon is surrounded by 4 bonds. See, this carbon is surrounded by 1, 2, 3, 4. Same way this carbon is also surrounded by 1, 2, 3, 4. Okay, like that while I am writing the structure or you are writing the structure, if you find any more than four bonds present between present on one carbon atom, then we have to check once. More than four bonds will not be there on one carbon atom. Okay, ma'am? This is the structure of ethane. Like this, we can go to further next one, third one. Third one, number is 3, C3. Keep this 3 in this formula, H, 2N plus 2, okay, 2 into 3 plus 2, 2, 3 is a 6 plus 2, 8, C3H8, that is the formula of third compound under alkanes. Okay, what is the root word? Prop. What is the root word? Prop. Because if you have 3 carbon atoms, root word will be prop. Plus, these are all coming under alkanes only. So anyways, primary suffix will be ane. So the name of this compound will become propane. Name of this compound will become propane. So what is the formula for propane? C3H8. Now the structure of this one is first carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. Second carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. Third carbon, 1, 2, 3, 4. Like that, every carbon is surrounded by 4 bonds. Number of hydrogens, check that one. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 hydrogens are there. Okay, it is clear. Next, D. D butane. C4H10. Check that one. N is equal to 4. Keep that N is equal to 4 here. 2 into 4 plus 2, 8 plus 2, 10. C4H10. C4H10 means butane. Because if number of carbon atoms 4, what is the root word? If number of carbon atoms equal to 4, then root word is bute. Ane. Bute plus ane, butane. That is the name of the organic compound, alkane, under 4. Okay? C4H10. Once try to draw the structure of C4H10. Okay, very simple, man. Easily, for easily understanding, I am telling that. Right, all the single bonds only, na? So 4 carbon atoms are there. Write the carbon atoms with single bonds. C single bond C, single bond C, single bond C. 4 carbons I wrote in series with single bonds. First carbon contains 3 hydrogens because it is satisfied by 1 bond only. Second carbon is satisfied by 2 bonds. That's why on second carbon I am writing 2 hydrogens only. Third carbon also is satisfied by 2 bonds. So I am going to write 2 hydrogens here. Then last carbon must contain 3 hydrogens because it has only 1 bond. Then remaining 3 must be hydrogens. In this way, now count the number of hydrogens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. C4H10. Okay, in this way, we are going to write the structure also. Now, up to 4 carbon atoms, I wrote C4H10, C5, C6, C7, C8. These 4 compounds, write on your own in the book. Okay. And check that one. Or send to me, I will check that one. Is it okay, ma'am? So, up to 4 carbon atoms, I wrote C4H10. Next, what is the compound? C5. Hydrogens, how many are there? C6, how many hydrogens are there? Depending on this formula, we can write that next series of compounds. Is it okay, ma'am? Like that, you can write up to C8. C8 means octane. Even structures also try to write them. That is your today's homework. Okay, this is about naming the alkanes. naming the alkanes. Now we will go to next one, that is alkene. We are going to discuss next series, that is alkenes series. Okay, now we will start that one. Let us see all of you. Alkenes have the general formula CnH2n only. CnH2n. Okay, so according to this formula, we have to go through the series of compounds. But before that, alkenes condition will be at least one carbon-carbon double bond must be there. Okay, so alkenes cannot be started with one carbon atom, because if you have one carbon atom only, remaining all must be hydrogens. Okay, between carbon and hydrogen, no double bond will be present, no chance, because hydrogen valence is one only. That's why there is no chance of formation of double bond between carbon and hydrogen. So alkenes must be started with two carbon atoms. First compound under alkenes will contain two carbon atoms, not one carbon atom. Okay, so let us see with two carbon atoms, C2, substitute this 2 in here, ma, H4. C2, H4. Now, how to give the name of this compound? If number of carbon atoms 2 are there, what is the root word? Ith. If number of carbon atoms 2 are there, root word is ith. Definitely this is coming under alkene. It should contain double bond. Okay. So what is the primary suffix? Ene. What is the primary suffix? Ene. Then the name of this compound will become ethene. Name of this compound will become ethene. Common name, ethylene. Mainly whatever the name I am telling, that is given by IUPAC. So that is called IUPAC name. This is called IUPAC name. This is called common name or general name. General names or common names will not follow any rules. We have to remember them. They will not follow any rules, ma. Simply we have to remember them. Is it okay? This is about first compound under alkenes. Alkenes should contain definitely carbon-carbon double bond. Okay. So definitely they have to be started with at least two carbon atoms. That's why first compound of alkene must contain at least two carbons. Okay, next. C3. C3, M is equal to 3, ma. Keep here. 2 into 3, 6. H6. C3, H6. How many carbons are there? 3 carbons. Prop. Plus, definitely double bond will be there. Ene. The name of this compound will become propene. Okay. First, before this propene, ma, structure of this ethene already we know. C double bond C. H. 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 This is the structure of C2H4. Coming to C3H6, structure is, draw 3 carbon atoms, ma. 3 carbons are there, ma. C3. So definitely I am drawing 3 carbons. At least one double bond must be there. So I am drawing here double bond, here single bond. Double bond here, single bond. Now, first carbon has 2 bonds. First carbon has 2 bonds. Total number of bonds present on carbon 4. In that, this carbon already satisfied 2 bonds. Then remaining 2 are hydrogens. Like that we have to draw. First, after writing the skeleton, this is the skeleton. Okay. Carbon is surrounded by how many bonds? First, 2 bonds. Then remaining 2 are hydrogens. So I wrote hydrogens. Now coming to second carbon, please observe carefully. You will write structures easily if you observe this one. This carbon has 1, 2, 3. Left side 2 bonds, right side 1 bond. how many bonds are there? 3. Total number of bonds? 4. Already it has 3 bonds. Then it must contain one more bond. That one bond is hydrogen. Like that we have to write the hydrogens. First count the number of bonds present on that carbon. After that number of hydrogens we can fix that one. Okay. After the final carbon, coming to this final carbon, it has one bond only. Correct, no? It has one bond only. Total number of bonds, 4. One bond is satisfied. Remaining three must be present. Those remaining three must be hydrogens. Now, once check the structure, all the carbons are satisfied by 4 bonds. Okay, even formula also satisfied. 3 carbons are there. Hydrogens 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. C3H6. Name of this compound is propene. While listening to the class, students who listen correctly, they will get one doubt, that is, why we are writing double bond here only? Why we are not writing double bond here? If you write double bond here, what will be happened? Like that you may get doubt. Okay, that clarity you will get while the molecules are going on. These are series of compounds now. After completion of series of compounds, so many examples we will see. Okay, while we are seeing those examples, you will understand if you write double bond here or double bond here, what is the difference? That one, you only get the idea, no problem. But definitely if you got the doubt, okay, keep that one in mind, that one will be cleared in next classes. Definitely it will be clear. Even you only will answer that. Okay, that is the thing. This is about C3H6. Name of this compound, propene. C3H6, name of this compound, propene. And this is the structure. Okay, shall I go to next one? Next one, number of carbon atoms, 4. C4. C4 means H8. 2 into N, 2 into 4, H8. Okay, ma'am. C4, H8. If number of carbon atoms 4 are there, then what is the root word? Bute. This must be contained by double bond. Then definitely its name ended with ene. Butene. What is the name of this compound? Butene. Now the structure of this compound is, how many carbons we have? What is the pattern I am following? Please, according to that, if you write, easily we can write the structure without mistakes. Please understand, all of you, what is happening here. Now, first I will see that how many carbons are there. I will write number of carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. These alkenes must contain at least one double bond. So, one double bond I am writing. Same doubt, the double bond I can write here or here, like that if you get, you will get clarity why we are going through so many explanations. No problem. Up to that, keep like that in mind. But now presently I am writing double bond here. Okay. C, double bond C. Okay. After writing the double bond, remaining are single bonds we have to write. At least one double bond I wrote, remaining single bonds. Okay. Now, concentrate on first carbon. It contains how many bonds? 2 bonds. Total number of bonds must be 4. Then remaining 2 are hydrogens. Coming to this carbon has 1, 2, 3 bonds. These two are common for these two carbons now. Okay. 1, 2, 3 bonds. 3 bonds means remaining how many hydrogens? 1 hydrogen. Because total number of bonds 4. In that it satisfied already 3 bonds. Then we have to write hydrogen, one hydrogen here. Coming to this carbon. This carbon has how many bonds? 2 bonds. Then remaining 2 hydrogens. Total number of bonds must be 4. Final carbon that contains one bond only. This bond only. Then remaining 3 hydrogens. Now count the number of hydrogens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 hydrogens, carbons 4, satisfied. C4H8, butene. Structure is cleared. Okay, now next one, C5 is there. further how to write that one also I will say. Okay ma, but before that you have to understand how I am writing the procedure correctly. First I am seeing the number of carbon atoms. Simply I am drawing the number of carbon atoms. 5 are there means 5 carbons I will write. Then alkenes means definitely it should contain one double bond. I am writing the double bond. Remaining are single bonds I am writing. Okay, according to the present bonds, hydrogens I am going to fix them. That is the way. Okay, no? Let us see now what about next compound. Next compound is C5. According to formula H10. H2N na? H10. C5 H10. What is the name? Root word pent. Root word is pent. It contains double bond na? So it must be contained by primary suffix ene. So the name of this compound will become pentene. Name of this compound will become pentene. Okay, now how to write the structure of this compound? Let us see. How many carbons it has? 5 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 carbons I wrote. At least one double bond must be there. I wrote double bond here. Remaining are single bonds. Remaining are single bonds. Okay. First carbon, 2 bonds are there. Remaining 2 must be hydrogens. Second carbon has 3 bonds. 1, 2, 3. Once again, 1, 2, 3. 3 bonds are there. 3 bonds means remaining how many? 1 bond. But that must be hydrogen. Next carbon, 2 bonds it has 2 hydrogens. Next carbon, 2 bonds it has 2 hydrogens. Next carbon has, last carbon has only 1 bond, that is this one only. Then remaining 3 must be hydrogens. So already present how many bonds are there? According to that we have to fix the number of hydrogens. That one is very important. Now see the number of hydrogens. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. 10 hydrogens. 5 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Okay, next. If we have single bond, that single bond is nothing but sigma bond. Correct? If you have double bond, then one must be sigma and another must be pi bond. While I am writing these structures, as you know what is the sigma and pi bond, okay, no confusion for you. If chemical bond is not completed, without completing that chemical bond, if I go through this structure, what is this single bond, what is the double bond, everything you will get doubt only. That's why chemical bond is very important to understand the structures of organic compounds very well. Okay, this is about alkenes topic. Is it clear, ma'am? If you are very much clear, up to C5 we completed, C6, C7, C8, 6, 7, 8, hexene, heptene, octene. These three compounds, try to write the structures, name, okay, all these things. Try it on your own. This is about alkenes. Next, we will go to next series of compounds, that is alkynes. How alkanes and alkenes contain general formula? Same way, alkynes contain general formula CnH2n-2. General formula of alkynes CnH2n-2. Okay, these alkynes must contain at least triple bond. There is a chance of triple bond between two carbon atoms. That's why these alkynes also must be started with at least two carbons, no chance of one carbon atom. So first compound of these alkynes contain two carbons, C2. According to that formula, 2 into 2, 4, 4 minus 2, 2, H2, C2H2. What is the root word? Number of carbon atoms 2, root word it, plus it contains triple bond. Triple bond means primary suffix ine. name of this compound will become ethyne. This is IUPAC name. Common name is acetylene. Common name is acetylene. Now let us see the structure. Two carbons we have. I wrote two carbons only. Definitely triple bond must be there. In between these two carbons only triple bond will be there. Okay, now how to write the hydrogens? This carbon has triple bond. Definitely one more bond must be present. That is hydrogen. Because carbon must be valence is satisfied with 4. Same like the right side carbon also contains three bonds. No? It should be satisfied by one more bond. That one more bond is hydrogen. Now see C2H2. Same structure only we have seen, linear. C2H2 structure is linear, hybridization sp. This is the information about first compound of alkyne, that is ethyne. Ethyne common name is acetylene. Okay, shall I go to next one now? B. C3H. N is equal to 3. Substitute this 3 here. 2, 3s are 6 minus 2. 6 minus 2, 4. C3H4. So next compound formula is C3H4. What is the root word? Number of carbons 3 na? Number of carbons 3 means root word pro. Definitely this must contain at least one triple bond. That's why ine. Name of this compound will become propyne. What is the name of this compound? Propyne. Next. Structure. How many carbons we have? 3 carbons we have. First, write the carbons. C, C, C. 3 carbons. Alkynes must contain one triple bond. At least one triple bond. I wrote triple bond here. Then, single bond here. Now, first carbon contains three bonds. Other bond must be hydrogen. Other bond must be hydrogen. Next. Second carbon contains four bonds. See, 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 bonds. So, no need to write any hydrogen. On second carbon, no need to write any hydrogen. Third carbon contains one bond. So, we must write 3 hydrogens on this one. Now this is the structure of C3H4. Total number of hydrogens are 1, 2, 3, 4. Carbons 3 with one triple bond. This is the structure C3H4. Now we will go to next one, C4. N is equal to 4. 2 into 4 minus 2. 2 4s are 8, 8 minus 2 6, H6, C4H6, that is our compound. Okay, what is the name? Root word is butte, number of carbons 4, na? So root word is butte, plus this must be contained by triple bond, ine. So the name of this compound will become butyne, root word plus primary suffix, butyne. Okay, what is the structure? It contains 4 carbons. I am going to write first skeleton, 4 carbons. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 carbons. At least one triple bond must be there. I am going to write triple bond here. Then remaining must be single bonds. Like this. How to write the hydrogens? First carbon has 3 bonds. So I am going to fix with 1 hydrogen. Total number of bonds 4. So one hydrogen must be there here. Second carbon already satisfied by 4 bonds. So no need to write hydrogens. Third carbon, 2 bonds are there. So remaining 2 hydrogens I wrote. Fourth carbon, 1 bond is there. So remaining 3 hydrogens I wrote. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 4 carbons, 6 hydrogens. Okay. Till this, whatever the examples we took, every example contain carbon and hydrogen only elements. These are all coming under hydrocarbons. These are all coming under hydrocarbons. Okay, next D. Under alkanes only D. That is C5, 2 into 5, 10, 10 minus 2, 8, C5H8, name of this compound will be pentyne. How many carbons we have? 5 carbons, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 5 carbons, one triple bond must be there, I am writing triple bond here, remaining all are single bonds. Then first carbon contains one hydrogen, second carbon will not be contained by any hydrogen, third carbon contains two hydrogens, fourth carbon contains two hydrogens, last carbon contains three hydrogens. Like this, structure of pentane can be explained. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Total number of hydrogens 8, number of carbons 5. Okay, ma'am? This is about how to give the names for alkanes, which are coming under hydrocarbons. Hydrocarbons are classified into two types, saturated and unsaturated. Saturated alkanes, unsaturated alkenes and alkanes. Okay, alkenes at least contain one double bond, alkanes at least contain one triple bond. In this way, we have to give the names. These are simple names only, ma. Till now we didn't get branched chains. When we get branched chains, little bit complication increases, but slowly I will teach, no problem. Okay, these IUPAC names are very important and which are very highly basic for next coming 12th class. So keep it in mind and follow every class regularly, then only it will be okay. If you practice, you will be perfect. Okay, ma'am, that is about today's class. I hope you understood this one. We will continue in next class. Thank you all. Have a nice day.